differences for the cost-benefit analysis is that some countries are more optimistic or more positive about how they can manage those costs. So welcome.
Thank you.
Just make sure this is working. Okay, that's good. Should turn on. Good. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks very much indeed. Basically, this morning, there's three things I'd like to talk with you about. The first one is to examine the cost and benefit drivers for smart meter rollout within Great Britain. The second one is to talk about how we, as a supplier, are trying to control our costs and optimise these benefits. And then thirdly, I'm going to conclude by talking you through the conclusions that I've reached. Okay, just a little bit about ScottishPower to start off with, in case anyone is not familiar with our organisation. ScottishPower is part of the Iberdrola Group, and as such, we are part of the fifth largest utility in the world, so part of a very big group. As such, that's very good in terms of learnings from other countries. So, for example, we've recently conducted quite an extensive benchmarking exercise with our colleagues in the United States, and hopefully a lot of the lessons that they learned there we can apply to the rollout within Great Britain. ScottishPower, as such, has 5.2 million domestic and business customers, so we are a relatively small player within the United Kingdom. But as such, we feel that's a benefit in terms of being agile and innovative. So we work together well as a company. We're a small organisation, we work together well, and we share learnings well as an organisation. Okay, let's start by going through some of the costs in terms of the smart meter rollout within Great Britain, and hopefully this will help Manuel a bit in terms of the European experience. So I've lifted this directly from the impact assessment that DEC produced, DEC being the Department of Energy and Climate Change within Great Britain. They produced this impact assessment in April of this year. What you can see from that is, on the right-hand side, all of these costs are supplier costs. We've got massive costs in terms of the smart meters themselves, so the gas and electricity smart meters, so it's both a gas and electricity smart meter programme within Great Britain, and also the IHDs. And I think the IHDs is an interesting thing, the in-home displays. So basically, we are mandated to offer every customer an in-home display. I think that raises some questions in terms of how relevant an electronic in-home display will be in years to come, as more and more people move towards the web and towards applications for their Android or their iPhone. We've also got costs in terms of the operation and maintenance of meters, and we also have system change costs as well over on the left-hand side of that diagram. So there is certainly a lot of cost falling on suppliers within Great Britain, and it's very important that we work with the government to control these costs as much as we possibly can. On the positive side of things, looking at the benefits, a large number of the benefits, and if you look at the top right-hand side there, a large number of the benefits are related to customer behavioural change. So this is a change moving towards customers being more environmentally aware and more energy efficient. And it's vitally important to us as an energy supplier that we do all we can to manage that with our customers. And I'll talk about that in a bit more detail later on. There's also some significant savings for us on an operational level. So in terms of inbound telephone calls, there's great benefits there. In terms of debt collection, in terms of having more accurate information in terms of billing, etc., great benefits there for us. That is, currently we write off just under 2% of our revenues on an annual basis, so that's quite significant. So we really hope that we can cut that down quite drastically through smart metering. We've also got a big benefit there in terms of avoided site visits. So the fact that we no longer have to go out and read meters for all customers, yes, there'll be some we still have to read for, but for the majority, these readers will be picked up automatically. Okay, so what are we doing as ScottishPower to control the cost of smart meter rollout? First of all, we see this as a great opportunity in terms of going out and competitively tendering for our meters and also the associated metering services. So these are the installation services for these meters. We very recently issued an RFP to a wide array of organisations, some of which, to be honest, traditionally we would not have engaged with, but we just see this as a step change in terms of how we're going to operate. So we've gone out far and wide and really cast our net wide on that. We want to have a very efficient implementation as an organisation, and as such, we will try whatever possible to geographically concentrate that. What we'd like to do is get geographic messages out to customers as well. To an earlier question around about, you know, what are smart meters? Do customers care? I don't think they care about smart meters as such, but what is important to customers is the services that can be driven off the back of smart meters. And that's something that we'll promote very much in terms of our service offering. We won't go in big style in terms of, you know, we're taking out your old meter and putting in a spanking brand new smart meter. That's not the game we're in, but what we'll do is we'll talk about the services we can offer. Our intention is to, from the trials we've done, to go out and do gas and electricity installs at the same time. So again, just optimising the efficiency of our operation. One of the things that's really important to us in terms of that is we need all the communication technologies available from day one of mass rollout. What we don't want to have to do is to go down a street and ignore certain premises because you need a different type of technology for that premise. So for example, in high-rise, multi-dwelling buildings, we may need to employ power line carrier to get the signal from the meter up to the in-home display. What I don't want to do is go down a street, do all the terraced houses or single dwellings in that street, but ignore the tower blocks. I like to blitz the whole street and make sure that we actually visit every customer and do that installation efficiently. I've mentioned earlier we need to carefully determine what assets and services will be required. So some customers may be satisfied with having no in-home display. Some may want a very basic in-home display, and others may want an enhanced in-home display. So again, we want to make sure that our messaging is right with our customers and understand fully what they want. As I mentioned earlier, we are casting our net wide, very wide indeed. We're going out to tens of providers in terms of looking for assets and installation services. So we very much are looking for the best service at the best cost for our rollout. Internally, we're also assessing our finance options and looking at the option as to whether or not to rent or buy the meters. Because again, back to my main point, it's all about reducing the costs, because at the end of the day, one way or another, these costs will impact the customer. And we want to do all we can as an organisation to drive these down. Okay, so what else are we doing in terms of controlling our costs? We have done, back at the tail end of 2010, start of 2011, we did a 30,000 metre plus smart metre pilot. And the purpose of that was to understand customer communications, to understand the products that customers wanted that smart meters could enable, to understand how efficient our installation operation could be. And just to start that learning process from these customers, we're going to continue to do small-scale pilots. We've got no intention of doing any mass rollout until the mass rollout begins within Great Britain. But we'll continue to do very small-scale pilots to learn from customers. We're working with the government regulator and consumer groups, and we feel it's vitally important in terms of controlling costs to work closely right across Great Britain. We're not just looking at this in a very insular way and just focusing purely on a supplier's perspective. We're engaging with all groups because we want to make sure that all groups understand the implications of decisions that are made and that nobody is under any illusion in terms of what could happen if a wrong decision is made and the costs that that could incur for the industry. In terms of internally, we're working to optimise our business processes internally. We're redesigning these processes, and I'll talk a bit about that later on. In a way, it's been, in some ways, it's been quite stressful for us as an organisation, but also opportune that we are introducing a new IT platform just now. So, as well as smart meter rollout, we've got this new IT platform, but in other ways, it gives us the opportunity to put these brand new processes right into a brand new platform. So we're working hard as an organisation in terms of optimising these processes and ensuring that our IT infrastructure will deliver. Okay, so on to the benefit side of things. We sincerely believe that smart metering is a game changer for us as an energy company. Recently, over the last few years, we've moved away from being a provider of gas and electricity towards being a provider of energy services. Some of our competitors have moved earlier and in greater volume than we have in terms of energy services, but we are introducing new energy services all the time just now, and we definitely see smart meters as being a key enabler to offer more energy services to our customers. We're creating that delivery infrastructure, re-engineering the processes, and implementing our new system. So we're really looking at the full end-to-end supply chain within our organisation, right the way from collecting information, voice of the customer information at the front end, all the way through that value chain, and looking at where the benefits that smart metering will bring can positively impact the way we run our organisation. In terms of energy efficiency, I mentioned at the start that a third of the benefits are attributed towards energy efficiency. So we are working very closely on how we interact with our customers over that messaging and how we can actually help them to save energy. As part of our pilot that I talked about earlier on, the 2010-2011 pilot, we developed a web portal for our customers, and that was recognised last year in an award, November last year. And we're delighted that we had designed something that others within the industry recognised us for, and obviously our customers were getting value from as well. So we definitely see the ongoing development of the web interface and, as I say, iPhone, Android apps as a way forward. I think it's also important to say that we will do energy efficiency education at the time of installation, but we'll also do that ongoing throughout the customer's lifetime with us, as we do currently. But I think that the benefits that Android apps and the web brings is you can do that on a more regular basis with customers if you can keep them engaged in terms of energy efficiency messaging. Okay. I think another really important aspect of this is the fact that our organisation will fundamentally change. So in the past, we've had a large chunk of the ScottishPower organisation involved in metering services, quite a large metering data retrieval workforce. We've also had a lot of contact centre staff historically as well. A lot of staff involved in back office processing in terms of debt collection, looking at exceptions, reading exceptions and billing exceptions. And a lot of that work is going to disappear. So we need to recognise that within the organisation, and we need to get ready for that change and where we're moving towards. So that's going to involve reskilling our employees to get them into roles that are going to be more relevant for the future. So one of these things will be through the provision of energy services and training our staff in terms of educating customers on energy services and driving that part of our business forward. We're also doing a lot of work, as I've touched on earlier on, in terms of driving self-service. So at the moment, we have 20% of our customers who are signed up to a totally online service, which I think is not bad at all. And we also have a number of other customers who will interact and self-serve on a regular basis. I've mentioned before the new technology and the customer access devices have become more and more prevalent. You know, already, you know, I often use the iPad when I'm at home, and I spend a lot of time, probably too much time, on that. And over time, that's going to become more and more prevalent. People will be using a lot of consumer access devices. We've also been doing a recent trial in terms of prepayment processes. So at the moment, within Great Britain, if people want to put credits onto their prepayment meter, they generally have to go out and visit an outlet and buy credits onto a key which they insert into the meter. We're looking at how that can be done more remotely to save people actually having to leave their home. And we're also educating our customers on an ongoing basis on the benefits that self-service will bring, not least of all the cost. Okay, so just to conclude, driving down the cost of smart metering installation is not going to be easy. It's going to take a lot of time and effort to do it. We've already spent a lot of time and effort in terms of our pilot, but that's just the start of a very long process, and we're going to keep on putting an amount of effort in, looking at innovating and driving things forward. This is not about doing what we've always done. It's about doing something differently. And as an organisation, we most definitely recognise that. The customer lies at the heart of the change within the benefits that smart metering bring. As I've mentioned, a third of the benefits are attributed towards customers changing their behaviour. And it's imperative for us as a supplier to work closely with our customers to deliver that. We're tightly controlling our costs. We are good at, being Scottish, we are pretty good at cost control, and we're continuing to do that. And as a supplier, we want to make sure, and we will deliver, and we just need to make sure that all other participants within Great Britain do the same thing. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, I'll let you go to coffee, but just to say one thing, having lived in Scotland for years, I can assure you they are very good at saving money. but really exciting. It's great to see a company that's so committed. I think for sure we can say that we're never going to achieve anything in this industry unless we believe in ourselves. And I think that just one question. Yeah, just.
You talked about the DCC, and I understand that is a nationwide service provided. If that service was not in place, what would that mean to your costs and to your benefits?
I think in terms of the DCC for Great Britain as a whole, one of the benefits that the DCC, the central hub, will bring are things like registration and change of supplier. So in terms of the GB benefit case, that is going to bring a lot of benefits in terms of efficiencies with that particular system. As a supplier, we could drive a lot of benefits without necessarily having the DCC in place. But for GB as a totality, there are definite benefits through having that centralized DCC.
One last question, which I'd like to just a yes or no answer, really, because of the time. But based on your knowledge of costs, we hear a lot about opt-in, opt-out to smart meters. I mean, there's opt-in and opt-out to services, of course, but in terms of smart meters, would your costs be higher if there was opt-in to smart meters or not?
They would be higher, yes. Yeah. Okay. Again, just maybe to expand a little bit on that, we've done some close work with our colleagues in the United States, and they came up with the regulator quite an innovative way in terms of the opt-in, opt-out argument. So basically, customers could choose to opt out of smart metering, but they would pay a price for doing that. And within Great Britain, I don't think that's a bad idea. I think it's a good thing to do, provided that price is cost-reflective for these customers.
Great. Thanks very much. I'll let you go to coffee, but thank you for all the speakers this morning. Thank you. Thanks. Okay, we'll catch up after the break. Thank you.